So what we can do to make this more complex is we can use multiple variables to make our poem even better. So currently I've set veg to onion. So what we would expect to see is mashed onion on the ceiling, green onion on the door, okay. Let's change that to floor because that would be a bit better, wouldn't it? There we go. And if we run this, we will just see onion. There we go. Cool. So we can make this a bit more interesting by adding more variables. Okay, so let's say veg 2 is radish and veg 3 is potato. Okay, and then if we then change these around, what we have is a bit more variety in our poem now. So we should see onion, radish and potato with any luck. Let's have a look. Okay, cool. So we can use multiple variables, and as long as we reference them correctly with exactly the same name, then whatever we set as the variable should come up here. Okay, now we could combine this with what we learned earlier. Okay, so we could use an input statement and we could say something like, please enter veg number 1. Okay, and then we could do the same for veg 2 and veg 3. So the user types in their own three vegetables and then their choices come up in the poem. So first of all, run it as I've just shown you, and then try replacing these with input statements and see if you can get the user to choose their own vegetables that will go inside the poem.